Hey everyone, Grindstone Radio, this is Daniel. I'm here with my co-host,
Eduardo.
And today we have a special guest, Liz Charles. Liz Charles is with the Women's Business Center of Cameron County. And Liz, why don't you give us an introduction?
Hi everyone, I'm Elizabeth Charles. I am the business counselor for the Women's Business Center of Cameron County, a nonprofit organization funded by the Small Business Administration and the Brownsville Chamber of Commerce. We are here to assist in any individual, not solely women, although we do cater to women, with starting or growing their business, whether it be with counseling services, financial assistance, or government contracting.
Awesome. So who is the Women's Business Center of Cameron County for, if I have a business or if I'm starting a business?
Both, actually. If you have a business and you want to find out how to grow your business, we can definitely help with that. If you are starting a business, we assist you from the initial stages all the way to the very end. So therefore, business planning, marketing, financing, just basically how to even manage a business. If you don't know anything about that, we help you out with that as well.
Awesome. And so how does it start? What's kind of like an ideal, like a case scenario where, you know, say someone wants to start a business, like what do we do? Like we go, do we apply for a program or
no.
Set an appointment with you?
Yes, we do ask that you set an appointment. So we are on Facebook and we of course have a website. And that website is www.wbc-cc.com. In which case you can actually set an appointment via the web. So it shows you all of my availability, in which case you can set your appointment. From there, we walk you through the process. So let's say Jane Doe walks in, has an idea for a business, is not sure how to implement it, or even if it's a good idea, she just wants to know some type of scenario in which case she needs help. She comes in, we walk her step by step through the process. We try to see if she needs a business plan, if her idea can move forward, if it's feasible, if it's viable, and then we help her out with the steps that she needs to take.
Great. And so what happens if John Doe walks in?
John Doe is more than welcome to walk in as well, and of course we'll help him out as just as we would help out Jane Doe. So if he has a business idea and he wants to come in and he wants to be able to find out more about how he can better his business with, if he's currently in business, or if he wants to start a business, we can walk him through that step as well. And of course, business plan is essential whether you have a business or you're starting one.
Cool. And I think one of the things that I've seen online too is you guys have some kind of business boot camp. Can you talk about that a little bit?
Yeah, of course. We actually just graduated our first boot camp as the Women's Business Center. And this is actually the seventh year that we do the boot camp. Prior to this, it was through the Brownsville Chamber of Commerce. However, it's the Women Entrepreneur Small Business Boot Camp. And we graduated 32 candidates this past graduation. We will be having an upcoming one in June or July, and that will be in the Weslaco area. Details will be coming soon via our social media links.
And how long is that boot camp for? Is it like pay tuition for that?
You do. There is a fee involved. So it depends on the action. The boot camp that we have, it's six sessions, six half-day sessions, and we cover everything from the beginning stages all the way to government contracting. So we talk a little bit about financing, a little bit about marketing, a little bit about how to get into a government contract and how to be able to get a certified as a women-owned small business.
Awesome. And what does that mean for someone's business to get certified?
So depending on the industry that you're in, you may be able to qualify for a certification with the government, in which case you would get particular set-asides for that government contracting. If you have a certification as a women-owned small business or a hub zone certification, there's several certifications out there, so it just depends which ones you qualify for. The government actually sets aside specific funds for those organizations, so that way they can get money for their business.
That's awesome. Well, great. So if, I know we're just kind of scratching the surface on everything you guys do, but if someone wants to get in contact with you or schedule an appointment, what's the best way to reach out to you?
The best way to reach out to us is, of course, by visiting us on the web, We are located on our website. However, for all those social media junkies out there, they can find us on Facebook. We definitely are very social. And you can find all of our information on our Facebook page, where you can also schedule your appointment or find out more about our Women's Business Expo, which is coming up on May 10th as well.
Awesome. Thanks so much for joining us.
Yeah, thank you.
And we'll catch you next time on Branson Radio. Peace out.
Later.